Hello, so this is a new devlog on the Arena War scheme. I have officially finished with 0.400. So to explain this big change, so here I worked on a lot of collision issues. I added some new mechanics, a lot more visual effects such as final bullet trail versions, added some post-processing. I have added brand new movement, which is the middle control, more animations, more UI elements, and so on. This was actually meant to be only like 10, 15 things that I wanted to do, but as you can see, it's way longer now, just to showcase all the changes in the game. If I press play, now we can instantly see that now we have a brand new loading section with press any button at the start. Now this area is not yet finished. I will have a background here in the future of the game, or maybe some gameplay happening in the background as we're in the options. But yeah, we have a brand new set of buttons, not using the default ones anymore, and there is a hover effect to show what you're clicking on. Settings, this is what the settings look like. Here we have new textures as well. It's visible that I have new font that I use. And now the confirm, reset to default, and back actually work properly. Not much options, mainly camera options that we can change resolution and sound, which doesn't work just yet. Now on the right here we have two new options, which is the difficulty set and the amount of players that we can have. So we're just gonna go with this. Now, for the movement and shooting logic, there is a brand new movement called middle control. It's where you move towards the middle and try to stay in the middle. It's good to combo with the spin fire, which used to be the worst one, especially if you're in a 1v1. As your chances of hitting something increase. So let's just try out the new sniper fire. Let's go with basic patrol edge. Oh yeah, another bug that I fixed is when we hover over and the stat is worse, where the red bar is, it's in the correct way around. This can be seen better looking at the other section. I mean older version of the game. So let's just go for a fast fire speed build. What do we have? The pack gun, and can we upgrade wheels to something? No, probably not. No. Yeah, so the credit system is something I want to work on, because there's not a lot of points once you select your logics. But yeah, I'm happy with this color, or maybe, yeah, let's go with that one. And let's go. So the biggest change here is the amount of particle effects. Now if we look here, there is the shooting and the smoke coming out from the fire, which I think is a very nice touch to it. Ooh, this could be a close one. Well, they just went past every time. There he goes. There's some really nice particle effects now for when you die. The explosion, hats going off, I think that's something that looks really nice. And then eventually the helmet just falls out of bounds of the map. So visually, I believe the game has changed significantly up to a point where I'm quite happy with how it turned out. When we win, the game, of course, can restart. Oh, let's go with the sniper gun. I mean, it doesn't matter which one I pick for that one. Let's go with the line and actually change to chase. And let's give ourselves some... Let's increase the rate of fire if we can, possibly. And let's go with these guys. Let's see how that's going to turn out for us. Ah, the enemy's not really working. Well, he does, but it's a very weak enemy robot. But yeah. If I quickly press play, so the settings work in the options. And that's where the currently game's at. So if we quit the game and we look at what's next to come. So for the next update, I want to focus on sound. I think I already said that sound is going to be the major factor. I'll also include 2v2 and 1v3 game modes. Of course, any bug fixes that I find in this version. There's going to be an introduction of the guided shots. So right now, the reader shoot forward, rotate randomly, or dead on aim at the target. The problem with this is that if they move, of course the bullet just travels in a straight line. If they move, they'll never get hit. So guided shots is going to be the final top tier shooting that you can have to prevent this from happening. Actually, now that I think about it, yeah, the slow-mo needs an upgrade, and of course wreckages sometimes get in the way. So just like the turret, they need to eventually disappear so they're not collidable at any point. I also want to add, now that I think about it, a what do I want to add? This is what happens when you're lost in your track. But yeah, I'll include that in the devlog for sure. Moving on, in the future versions, I kind of want to work on additional options for languages, and a small tournament modes and so on. I don't think I'll have enough time to get to this version as I'm getting close to the deadline, but the sound update will definitely be there. I'm getting a better idea of what I want to do after I finish with this, which will include a lot of restructuring, but that will be left for another video.